Hafiz or Wahaj.
And
who was my second daughter? Okay, she was a Muslim. She was a very good Muslim. She, you know, like I said, biased Muslim. She was definitely a born leader. She established two Muslim Students Association, one at Stuyvesant High School and one at, she was the president of the Muslim Students Association at Stuyvesant High School, and she was also, she also established the Muslim Students Association at Manhattanville College. Individual who just made an impact no matter where she went. You know, she had a pleasant personality, she was always helpful. She was compassionate, she cared about people, and she just made a, she just made an impact no matter where she went. She just helped out wherever she could. As a daughter, she was just wonderful to have as a daughter. She was helpful around the house. She just had a pleasant personality. She had a mischievous laugh sometimes when she would really get that hearty laugh in. But she just had like a gentle spirit about her. She was very focused and studious in school. And she just seemed to be a very mature, developed person who was just here for a short time. She died like she passed on 1 month before she was due to graduate from college, and exactly 1 week after she had the birth of her baby. I wanted something as a legacy to live on, as a celebration of her name, as a celebration of who she was, something tangible, you know, that I could look at for myself, but also my children can have it, my daughter can have it, my daughter's 17 now. I wanted something that could live on.
Just something,
just something documented, even for the community. Anybody that knew her in Manhattanville, anybody that knew her in the Muslim community, anybody that knew her. I wanted something as a live record that will live on to showcase who she was. And she made such an impact at Manhattanville College that the students got together and established a scholarship for her. And also they planted a tree in her name. So she made that much of a positive impact that people felt like they wanted her name to live on. And so after that, over the years, I have continued the scholarship in her name, that the college would pick, you know, someone who was like her so that her name could continue. So, you know, I think that we should celebrate people who make a positive impact and leave a legacy for them.
Charlene Smith Rodriguez, Manhattanville graduates, parents, and guests. I'm grateful to be here again at the 2012 graduation. It has been 17 years since Basma Taliba went at Manhattanville. She was 21 years old and some months when she made her transition. She accomplished a lot during her short period here with us on Earth. Basma was a young, pious Muslim woman who was used to our transition to the other side. We don't know how much time we have here. What will we need?
Thank you.
She hit, you know, life points, meaning she got married, she had a baby, and she, you know, she just made an impact on her little short life.